Hi and welcome back to my little corner of the internet. Today I'm making a work dress where there's a lot of pieces in a fairly simple dress. One of those that looks simpler on paper than it does in real life. I have to make some pleats on the top of the sleeve. These two big pieces are the front piece and the back piece. That's going to be pleated together as well. On the top, I've been sewn on I think it's called a yoke. Where I've made my own, where I'm going to make my own bias tape to put on as well. And the pattern is from Laughing Moon. So what I'm going to start off with is spaced the inner layer and the outer layer of the top of the dress together, and then I'm going to treat that as one piece of fabric. I'm just going to baste those together. This is the back piece. And this is an 1840s, 1860s work dress or maternity dress. This is the front piece. I'm going to do exactly the same thing as I did on the back piece, making sure that I mirror them so I get two pieces that is turning the right way. Even though it's not that important with this fabric because it doesn't really have an outer side and an inner side. It's just some cheap polyester that I could find, because you have to use 7 meters, and 7 meters is a bunch of money. This is my first time making it, so I needed something that wasn't too expensive, but still looking pretty, so I would wear it. So all of this is just polyester. I would have loved it if it was in cotton instead. But that's the first part done. Let's put that aside. Now I'm going to pleat the upper part of the sleeves. And these sleeves don't sit on the top of your shoulder. These sleeves sit underneath your shoulder. So the pleat is going to be on the side of my arm more than on top of my shoulder. I'm just marking off all the assembly marks before I start pleating. And again, I have taken the pieces and mirrored them, so I'm making sure that I have two pieces that are turned the right way. And here you're supposed to pleat them on the outer side of the fabric, or the right side of the fabric, and not on the wrong side or on the inner side. You have to do this, or else the pleats are going to sit wrong when you fold them. This will make a lot more sense if you ever try to make this dress yourself. Just checking that I have the right direction of the pleats as well. These are pleated towards each other at the middle, or to the middle. One sleeve done. I'm going to do exactly the same with the other sleeve. This is the outside, and this is the inside. Now I'm going to do the same thing, but with the big pieces. And I'm going to do this before sewing together center back, because the fabric is too big. If I sew it together at center back first. But otherwise the technique is exactly the same. I'm putting in a pin where the pleat is going to be, and then I'm going to fold it as is shown on the pattern. And I'm going to use my little tartan stripes as a guide to make it more easy on myself or for myself. This was not hard at all, but it just took a lot of time. So even though this is a simple work dress, it's going to take some time to make, because there's so much prep before you can actually sew. And again, doing this on the other piece here, you can better see what I'm doing with the pins, pinning them in where the pleats are, and then I'm going to fold those over. And before I could even cut out my fabric, I had to, you know, tape it all together. And it took me like 3 days because the pattern pieces are so big. And I think there was about 200 pieces of paper. But yeah, that's a part of the process. And here I'm just finding where the waist is. And I ended up altering this on a later date because my waist isn't as far down as it is on the pattern. And let's make some piping. First I sewed all the bias tape together. Now I'm going to give it a little press at all the seams, and then I'm going to put in the string. I use regular kitchen string because that was the only thing I could get here in my little hometown. And I'm going to be using a zipper foot so I can sew as closely to the edge as I can, but without sewing over the string. And that's what I'm going to do here, make some piping. I'm just folding in the string and then sewing as close as I can to the string, but without sewing onto the string. Here we have some piping. First time I have ever made this, and it's actually working. Now I'm sewing together the shoulder seams. Why is that so hard to say? Just giving those a little finger press. Now I'm going to put on the piping. I accidentally made the piping not wide enough, so that's why there's a little gap between the piping and the seam allowance, or there's a little gap in the seam allowance. Because I had to go from inches to centimeters, because I don't do inches, so that's what happens sometimes. Here I'm sewing the center back before doing anything else. I honestly think this is the biggest dress I have made so far on this channel, with the most fabric, hence the 7 meters of polyester tartan. And here I'm making the last fold at center back, or the last pleat at center back. I'm just going to give that a little stitch so it won't go anywhere. And I'm doing this to the front piece as well. Here I'm sewing where I think the waist is going to be, but I ended up picking that up and moving it a bit further up. And now I'm going to put the top part together with the bottom part. Again, remembering not to sew over my piping, just up to my piping. So it's going to be shown at the seam. Let's put in some pockets, the biggest pockets ever. You can fit my computer into these pockets. But that's the whole idea of a work dress, or in my case, some cozy clothes. I need pockets for snacks, so these are so important. And I sewed those first before I sewed them, or sewed them on before I sewed this side seam, and then I sewed them shut. A bit like I do on my Edwardian skirt. And before sewing the sleeves, I'm going to put in a gathering thread at the bottom and a small one at the top. From the side seam into the pleats, or on the side, from the side seam to the pleats, if I could talk. And I'm just doing this so it's going to be easier to put in, and because I'm going to put on a cuff on the sleeve edge. the sleeves. Again, give it a little stitch on the on the top of the sleeve so the pleats won't go anywhere. And here I'm putting in some piping at the armhole or the arm's eye before I sew on the sleeve. Making sure to cross that over at the center back or at where the piping is on this on the back piece of the dress. And let's put in some sleeves. These are actually fairly simple to put in. Here I'm making the cuffs. Again, so many steps to this little simple dress. I'm going to put the cuffs on. But honestly, I think if I make another dress, it's going to be a lot quicker because now I know how to do it. And I really want to make one in like flannel, like blue or red flannel. So it's going to be like really cozy clothes. Let's sew that on. And because it's too small to put on my sewing machine, I'm sewing it from the inside instead of the outside. Folding that over, and I'm going to give that a little stitch so it won't go anywhere. I should have done this by hand, but I did it on the machine because I was too lazy to do it by hand. Let's put on the little collar. There are two variations of this dress in the pattern, and I chose the one with the collar. There's one without, and one without cuffs as well. But I just love a more quote-unquote masculine look, so I really love collars and cuffs. And I'm putting in the putting on the inside first, and sew it. And I'm going to sew that, fold that over, fold that in, and then sew that again. So I kind of encase the seam allowance. This is the waistband where my camera ended up twisting on my tripod, so this is a little interesting footage, but you can see what I'm doing. Just sewing them together. Then I'm sewing in some tape to make it more sturdy. And I then sewed that together again, and then I turned it and sewed the edges or the ends. That was a bit tricky, but I made it work. And we are almost done here. I'm just correcting the where my waist is. Just mark that off. And I'm going to put pins in where I made the marks, and then I'm going to sew that. And then I'm going to pick the other waist or the other waistline part. Nothing to it really. Here I'm folding in where the closure is going to be. You could sew the front bit all the way up, all the way almost up to your waist, but I ended up just not doing that and then made it fairly open at the bottom. Here I'm folding in the collar bit. As you can see, I've made some buttonholes, and I'm going to be sewing in buttons at the center front. Just simple white buttons. This is the collar that I folded in and then sewn, as I just said. And here I'm just doing all the finishing touches. Going to fold up the edge on the bottom of the dress, sew that. Put in some buttons, and then we're done. Nothing to it really. But I'm totally going to make another one in some flannel or maybe some, you know, cheap cotton or something, because this is totally going to be my new go-to cozy clothes instead of sweatpants, I hope. Well, in theory. Here it is on. A lovely and fluffy and with the biggest pockets ever. Here you can see the buttons and how far they go down. and that the shoulder seam is not on top of the shoulder but at the side of the arm. So yeah, a work dress. And if you're still watching, then like this video, subscribe, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!